Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you log periodic antenna. Before I start my explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of log periodic antenna. After that, I'll explain you log periodic dipole array, in which I'll explain you structure of log periodic dipole array as well as parameters of log periodic dipole array. After that, I'll sum up this session by explaining applications and advantages of log periodic antenna. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of log periodic antenna. Log periodic antenna functions over a wide range of frequencies, because of which it is also known as frequency independent antenna. See, log periodic antenna is having broadband characteristics. That's why it is also known as frequency independent antenna. First of all, you need to understand what is the meaning of log periodic antenna. See, log periodic antenna means here we have a logarithmic function of frequency. Periodic means its radiation characteristics, that is repeating periodically as a logarithmic function of frequency. So log periodic antenna that is having radiation characteristics, that is repeating periodically as a logarithmic function of frequency. Let me take one example. Let us consider we have log periodic antenna that is having base 10 of log. So in that case, let us assume right now antenna functions at frequency of 1 gigahertz. So its radiation characteristics that will be repeating at next frequency, that is 10 gigahertz. After 10 gigahertz, its radiation characteristics that will be repeating at 100 gigahertz. After 100 gigahertz, its radiation characteristics that will be repeating at 1000 gigahertz. So based on logarithmic function of frequency, its radiation characteristics that will be repeating periodically over here. Here I have considered example of base 10. Let me take one more example. Like here, as if we have base 2 of log. And let us assume here we have frequency at which it is operating at 1 gigahertz. So its radiation characteristics that will be repeating at 2 to the power 1 means 2 gigahertz. Its radiation characteristic that will be repeating at 2 to the power 2 means 4 gigahertz. After 4 gigahertz, its radiation characteristics that will be repeating at 2 to the power 3 means 8 gigahertz. That is how periodically its radiation characteristics that is repeating as a function of log with respect to frequency, right? If you observe one diagram which I have drawn over here, so that is of log periodic antenna with array of dipole, where you see here length of dipole that is largest over here, and as you move in this direction, length is decreasing, and as you move in this direction, spacing between dipole that is also decreasing. So that is how we used to form log periodic antenna. Now I'll take one practical example of log periodic antenna with array of dipoles. In log periodic dipole array, we connect dipoles in parallel with each other. But geometry is quite interesting. Let me explain you that. See, here we have in total n plus 1 dipoles, where this is first dipole, this is second dipole, this is third dipole, this is nth dipole, and this is n plus 1th dipole. Here, length of dipole that is increasing as you move in this direction. First dipole that is having length L1, second dipole that is having length L2, third dipole that is having length L3, and as you move in this direction, you can observe length of dipole that is increasing. Here one more observation that you need to do. If you move in this direction, then spacing between dipole, that is also increasing. You can observe that. And that is happening as per this geometry, where if you observe this angle alpha, so that is bounding length of this dipole. Like first one is having length L1 as you move in this direction. Second one will be having length L2, but obviously it will be higher than this. So this alpha, that is bounding length of dipoles over here. Based on length of dipole, we have one very essential parameter, that is scale factor. So scale factor, that is tau, and that is ln divided by ln plus 1. So ln is this divided by ln plus 1. So but obviously that is lower than 1, right? Here, if you observe the spacing, so spacing is arranged as per this ratio only. So scale factor, that is ln divided by ln plus 1, as well as it is rn divided by rn plus 1. So here rn plus 1, that is a distance of this dipole with respect to origin. Rn, that is distance of this dipole with respect to origin, right? So here, as length is increasing over here, spacing is also increasing. And based on that, scale factor is there. If you observe the real example of log periodic dipole, then here you can observe this dipole is having highest length. And as you move in this direction, length of dipole, that is decreasing. If you observe the spacing, then as you move in this direction, spacing is also decreasing. So that is how structure is there. Now I'll explain you how feeding mechanism is there. If you observe here, we have transmission line, or you can say feed lines, that is connected with this first dipole. After that, with second dipole, see, there is a cross feed. With next dipole, there is a cross feed. With next dipole, there is a cross feed. So here feeding is cross feed with this dipoles, right? And you can observe here, see, we have two pipes. With upper pipe and with lower pipe, we are connecting these poles. And we have these two pipes in parallel over here because of we need to provide cross feed connection with these dipoles, right? Here there are few essential parameters that you need to understand. Like what will happen as if you have larger value of alpha. See, if you have larger value of alpha, in that case, scale factor, that will be small. Why? The reason is, if you have larger value of alpha, then but obviously this element and this element, that will be having larger difference in terms of length. Scale factor is ln divided by ln plus 1. If ln plus 1 is way larger compared to ln, then but obviously scale factor will be lower over here, right? So for larger value of alpha, scale factor is small. And for smaller value of alpha, scale factor is large. If you have smaller value of alpha, in that case, difference in length over here, that will decrease, right? That's why ln divided by ln plus 1, that will be having bit larger value, that you can say. Larger means it will be always lower than 1, but its value is bit large compared to previous case, right? See, if you have large value of alpha, then number of elements will be less. But obviously, if you have large value of alpha, in that case, number of elements, that will be less over here, right? The reason is, if you have wide angle, then you cannot have more distance over here, right? So in large value of alpha, we have less number of elements and separation will be large over here. While in case of small value of alpha, we have more number of elements and we need to have less separation between elements. So that is how we need to keep few parameters in our brain when we design log periodic antenna using dipole array, right? Now I'll be discussing about applications of log periodic antenna. See, log periodic antenna, that we use it for broad frequency ranges, right? And we need wide range of frequencies in case of broadcasting of TV signal, in case of broadcasting of FM signal, right? So here in TV broadcasting, in radio broadcasting, in ham radio, in mobile communication, we use log periodic antenna. See, log periodic antenna, that is also useful in test and measurement as well as in scientific research, right? Now I'll be discussing about advantages of log periodic antenna. See, log periodic antenna, that is having wide band characteristics. That's why it is also known as frequency independent antenna, right? See, log periodic antenna that can have directional performance by increasing number of elements. If you have more number of elements, then but obviously it will be having directional characteristics, right? And it is having lower VSWR. See, lower VSWR, that one can understand based on its broadband characteristics, right? So if you observe its return loss characteristics or VSWR characteristics, then it is having wide bandwidth with lower value of VSWR, or you can say return loss, right? So that is how basic parameters are there with log periodic antenna. See, this is just a one example of log periodic antenna where I have considered dipole array with log periodic antenna, but there are many other geometries that is also possible with the use of log periodic antenna. I hope you have understood this session. Still, if anything that I would like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.